away we go. Well, good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to the journey of Storybook Land. My name is Tammy, and I'll be your captain and storyteller as we travel aboard the Flora. For your safety, remain seated, keeping hands, arms, legs, and feet inside the boat. And parents, please supervise your children as we wouldn't want our story to take any unexpected turns. Now, while most people visit far-off places through the pages of a book, those that visit in person, whether through a rabbit hole or with the help of pixie dust, often find the way into the magical or even menacing. But not to worry, even though we've just been swallowed by Monster the Whale, the very same whale who swallowed Pinocchio on his daring journey, we're really being transported into a magical place called Storybook Land. Of course, our story does begin with Once Upon a Time, and in this case, it's about a big bad wolf who lives in the cave on the left and is always chasing after the three little pigs who live across the canal in these houses. The first made of straw, the second of sticks, and the third house made of wolf-proof bricks. And it seems as if our journey is taking a somewhat strange turn. We're just around the river bend is the quaint English village home of Alice, where one golden afternoon, she chased White Rabbit into a rabbit hole and fell down, down, down into Wonderland, where things, of course, became curiouser and curiouser from there. Storybook London is filled with fantastic places created to inspire storytellers, places like London Park, where Peter Pan, John, Wendy, and Michael Darling followed the second star to the right and straight on till morning with the help of Tinkerbell's pixie dust on their way to Neverland, where they never, ever have to grow up. And places like Agrabah, City of Mystery and Enchantment, where a street rat named Aladdin first bumped into Princess Jasmine in the marketplace and stole her heart. Though the two were from different worlds, through the power of luck, with the help of their friend Genie, they were married and now live in the Sultan's palace atop the hill. These magical places are where love shines, like the twinkling lights in the archways above us. The very same archways where Aladdin and Jasmine soared over, sideways, and under on their magic carpet ride to a whole new world. And while all good stories are filled with light and love, they also have their dark places of mystery and magic, like the Cave of Wonders just ahead. The treasure bears a curse that can be lifted only by the genie in the lamp. And legend has it, whoever frees the genie will be granted three wishes. Let's make a wish and see if it comes true. Snow White wished to be safe, and as she fled from the evil queen, she came upon the cozy forest cottage on my right, home of the seven dwarfs who offered her shelter and thanks for her kindness. You may even see their mime or hear them whistle while they work. And Cinderella wished to go to the ball, but her wicked stepmother forbade it, leaving her behind in the Blue Ridge Chateau on my left. Her fairy godmother granted her wish, but when Cinderella again leave the ball by midnight, her coach was turned back into a pumpkin, and it's still sitting up on top of the bridge today. And while magic has its limits, thankfully love does not, for Cinderella married Prince Charming and is living happily ever after in the castle above their kingdom. Dreams do come true, and like wishes, they inspire our stories here. While some dream of happily ever after, others dream of drifting off to sleep on hills of quilted flowers, like those in the giant patchwork quilt on my left, which features a variety of over 50 different leaves and is inspired by the magazine 30 and the Disney City cartoon Lullaby Land. There's magic all around us here at Storybook. All the plants, trees, and flowers you see are in fact real. They've just been miniaturized by a process known only to Tinkerbell and a few of our Disneyland gardeners, and magically grow only about 1 inch per year. And that's just part of the reason this place was such a favorite of our beloved master storyteller Walt Disney, and continues to inspire new stories. Stories like The Wind in the Willows with Ratty Mole and Mr. Toad, whose stately manor is on the left. But sorry folks, J.K.'s Toad isn't home right now. He's off in his motor car on a wild ride to nowhere in particular. And that brings us to the Kingdom of Arendelle, with a castle by the sea, a ship at anchor, and Elsa's ice palace rising from the snow-covered mountains. It's here sisters Anna and Elsa first met their frozen friends, Olaf, Kristoff, and Sven, and where there is something stronger than Elsa's magic, and that's the power and love of family. Well, Alpine Village on my right. So with Farmer named Geppetto wished upon a star that his puppet would become a real boy. And Pinocchio saved Geppetto from the belly of Monster the Whale. The blue fairy granted that wish. Geppetto's wish is like those found in so many fairy tales, like the one that led a little mermaid named Ariel to follow Prince Eric to his castle on the right. Inspire her to give up her life under the sea, take her first steps on unsteady legs, and fulfill her dream of becoming a part of our world. Hers is a story that begins in the shadows of her father's deep tragedy that had been watered in the sea of a mess that went my way. She's a little bit of a story, but she's a little bit of a story, so possibly in the rest.